Yo, we got Paul saying dad jokes, thinking he's all cool. Skylar playing piano before she's even done school. Isaac playing hockey like a real jockey. Then we got Sawyer rocking on the keys. Then there's Macy, a show within a show. You'll see what that means. Johnny and Amelia dancing and playing. Becky showing off all the pictures she's been taking. Annabelle, my oh my, rocking the mic, giving praises to God on high. Monica doing something you hardly ever see. Gideon with his army of Lego showing how to let go. Then Sawyer's back for piano round two. Then someone singing beautifully, try to guess who. Brooklyn doing a dance she put together at home. Kalia being playing for a year, what a treat to hear. Mila singing away, that little voice that could carry us away. Hux, are you jumping on the bed, telling us how to kill a fish dead? And Alice on the strings, how beautifully she sings. And then there's Chris baking, he's last but not least. All right, now you got an idea of what's going down for our Lakeside's Got Talent. So here's the first video with Paul and some dad jokes.
They've given me the job of making everyone else look good. And so I have for you to begin our series of talent escapades, a series of dad jokes. My son is reading a lot of stuff for school these days, and he looked at me yesterday and said, "Can I have a bookmark?" I burst into tears. 22 years old, and he still doesn't know my name is Paul. The other day, I caught him chewing on electrical cord. I had to ground him. But currently, he's doing better. He's starting to conduct himself properly. I built a model of Mount Everest, and he asked me, "Is it built to scale?" I said, "No, it's way too small. It's built to look at." The pandemic is definitely going to cause a baby boom in 2021, which means in about 12 years, we're going to have to suffer through the quarantines. Wendy and I both grew up on farms, so I asked my dad, "How do you get a farm girl to marry you?" He told me, "First, a tractor." The other day, Wendy stamps her foot and says, "You haven't been listening to a word I say, have you?" And I thought, that's a weird way to start a conversation. She was accusing me of hating her relatives, but I said, "That's not true. For instance, I like your mother-in-law far more than I like my mother-in-law." Of all the inventions of the last 100 years, the dry erase board has to be the most remarkable. I'm kind of hoping I can erase those last 3 jokes. Look, if pronouncing my B's as V's makes me sound Russian, so be it. But language is hard sometimes. I got the words jacuzzi and yakuza mixed up, and now I'm in hot water with the Japanese mafia. Pre means before, and post means after. To use both of those prefixes together would be preposterous. I've recently discovered that I'm terrified of elevators, so I'm taking steps to avoid them. My therapist says I second-guess every decision that I make. I'm not going to tell that joke. God got bored watching the earth turn, so after 24 hours, he just called it a day. I think I better too. Thanks, and enjoy the show.
Hey, Lakeside, Isaac here. Today I'm going to be showing you my talent, hockey. Hope you enjoy the video.
Two.
Peace, brother.
Yes, finally!
Welcome to Lakeside's Got Talent.
First up, Rebecca with Swan Lake.
Next, we have Charles C. and Max with some new dog tricks. Last, but certainly not least, Ginny the Magical. Let's hear it for all of our performers!
And I'm gonna play Baby Shark.
Nice work, buddy.
Who am I in grace?
sacrifice in paradise. We're in the plans that you made, the plans that you made. Because I'll never hold the picture of the whole horizon in my view. Because I'll never rip the night in two. It makes me wonder, who am I? Who am I? Who am I? And great are you, great are you, Lord.
God chose Gideon to fight the enemy.
The Midianites were the enemy, and they hated God. So God told Gideon to make an army.
God said the army was too big.
half the army left. Then Gideon was ready to fight, but God said the army was still too big.
What?
So then only a small army remained.
Gideon spied on the huge Midianite army. From a dream, he learned that God would help him defeat Midian. Gideon worshipped God. Gideon told his small army how to defeat Midian. At night, they snuck into the Midian camp and blew horns and smashed drums. The sleeping Midianites were scared and confused and started fighting each other. Soon Gideon's army had defeated them. Gideon was God's warrior.
To a losing game. Ooh. Ooh, all I know, all I know, loving you is a losing game. How many pennies in the slot? Giving us up didn't take a lot. I saw the end before it began. Still I carried, I carried, I carried on. I spent all of the love I saved. We were always a losing game. Small town boy in a big arcade. I get addicted to a losing game. Ooh, ooh, all I know, all I know, loving you is a losing game. Ooh, ooh, all I know, all I know, loving you is a losing game. I don't need your games, game over. Get me off this roller coaster. Ooh, ooh, all I know, all I know, loving you is a losing game.
Hi, it's Brooklyn, and I learned a dance during COVID that I want to share with you guys. Hope you enjoy. Thank you.
restaurant show called He Loves Us by Us. Okay, let's go.
Where do you go with all your stuff?
Out to the lake. And then you drill a hole and then set the lines. And then if you catch a fish, get the rod, reel it up, and then you check if it's a keeper. If it's a keeper, you keep it.
Welcome to Cooking with Chris. I have spent seconds of my life studying the depths of the culinary world. Hello, and welcome to Cooking with Chris. I am here today to give you some of my top secret recipes. Now, for our first recipe, let me just pull up the recipe because it's a very detailed and specific thing. Yep, I've got it down. Gordon Ramsay would be proud. Okay, We are going to be making banana bread. For what you need, first you need a plate. Next, bananas. Now, you can kind of choose any banana. I generally like the yellow ones, but green works too. All right, I've got a nice yellow one right here, okay? It's looking perfectly ripe. Okay, what you're gonna do is you're going to peel the banana. Now, take this banana. You can put it on your plate just like that. Next, what you're going to do, some bread. You can choose any bread you want, but frozen bread generally doesn't work. Take your bread. You don't need that anymore. Okay. And your banana, put it in the bread and wrap it. And there you have it, folks. The number one banana bread brought to you by Chef Chris. We are going to be making grilled cheese, Icelandic grilled cheese. I'm gonna cut the cheese. Nice big blob of cheese right there. Look at that. Delicious. This is a nice, rich, medium cheddar that I picked out myself from the supermarket. Next, you need a frying pan. I'm choosing this one because it was right there. Okay, then you're gonna go over to the stove.
Come on here, let's take a look at this.
Okay, so you got your stove and your frying pan. Okay, now, this is very important. You need to set the dial to exactly 6.4. See that? All right, it's at 6.4. Now, come back over here to the cheese. Take your cheese. Now, look very carefully here. Gently drop it into the pan. Okay, now it's gonna sit there for a little bit as we move on to our next recipe, and I'll come back to that. Now, this cheese has been grilling perfectly at 6.4. Somebody turned it off. Awkward. Anyways, it's supposed to be grilled at 6.4. As you can see, the grease is just oozing out, which is exactly what you want. And now, all you need to do is carefully plop it down, and there you have it, folks. A perfect grilled cheese. Now, what's gonna happen is we are gonna be making fish and chips. Okay, the first thing you need to do is make the chips. Now, you take these, nice big handful, perfectly laid out right there. All right, maybe throw a few more in there. Okay, now, I generally love salt.
Okay, so what you need, add a little bit more salt to these, all right?
Now, next up is the fish. They came right out of the ocean like probably a year ago, okay? And it's the tuna, okay? What you're gonna do, see how there's juice there? Oh, excellent. All right, and now, look, bring the camera in nice and close here. All right, this is important. All you have to do is dump. Oh yeah, look at that. Perfect. Oh yeah, okay. And then you can layer it. Oh, delicious fish and chips. Okay, so I can't give you all my secrets, so we're gonna do one more. Really, really quick one. This one is apple sauce. The first thing you need, a nice, juicy, moist, plump apple. The next thing you need, tomato sauce. All right, I've got some old tomato sauce right here. All you do, and this is very important, apple sauce right there. Thank you, Chef Chris. The key lime pie. Eat the pie plate. Sicilian lime juice.
Now you take Sicilian lime juice. Bring the camera in here for a second. It's crucial. And all you do, oh yeah, squeeze it in there. Look at that. Perfect. All right. See? Some Sicilian lime juice. Next, take a key.
You can literally just take any key. throw it in the oven, and you don't even need to bake it. It'll be ready in about 30 minutes. You have a beautiful key lime pie. If you zoom in here, look at that. Look at that key in there. Perfect. All right. Oh yeah. Look at that key lime pie from Sicily. Yes. And lastly, we have a hot dog.